everyone. It's Roberta from Roberta's Artistic Adventures. I have some happy mail. I bought some stuff today, or I bought some stuff the other day and received some of it the last couple days. So I'm going to open it up doing a happy mail. And my granddaughter Cheyenne is doing the camera. And then we are going to be doing some jelly printing. Some of the crazy or the art glitter glue and a brayer from Speedball. It's one of the better brands, so I wanted to get that one. This one is supposed to be the two art glitter glue. Two-pack ultra-fine metal tips. I have two of those, so... Well, actually, it doesn't come with the little cap to use it, so I won't be able to use that. I'll have to get it, though. And then this one is the jelly plate. The kitchen knife does not work.
It's called the butter knife. You want me to grab your real knife or a pair of scissors?
You would think I would have grabbed a pair of scissors. Hold on. There we go. I've been wanting a jelly plate for a very long time. And I got the... What is this size? 8x10? So I'm going to keep the packaging to keep it stored in while I'm not using it. That's the directions that it has and how to use it. Of course, I'm not going to read the directions. I've watched enough people playing, so I just want to get to it. Jelly plate comes and it has a cling on the front and a cling on the back. And I'm going to put the glue away because we're not going to be using the glue. And open up Speedball because we need this roller, the brayer. And I'm going to take just the top one off. My granddaughter Cheyenne is going to come over here and she's going to watch me do a couple of colors and playing around, and then she'll be able to do a couple too. So what you want to do is you want to put a couple of drops of paint over this.
So does it wash off?
It will, but you generally are wanting to put it on papers, and so I have a bunch of book papers I was going to do this on. And a little bit of pink. Blue and pink make purple, and pink and yellow make this really awesome neon orange color. And so
papers at me, huh?
Yes. You need to have one on the side to brayer off. And then I'm going to have a couple that I'm going to be doing. Okay, so Cheyenne, what you'd be doing is you would roll up. And then you can roll back down. Pick up more. And see how it changes the colors?
Looks like paint.
Okay, so if I wanted, I could brayer off onto this, and then I can use this paper for something. But And sometimes they have their printer paper, just blank ones, the cheap paper, and they will cover it so they don't get it on their hands, but I don't care, we can just wash our hands off, right? And then you lay them off to the side and let them dry. Let me go get some of my stencils.
Shower stencils.
You want to get colors that aren't going to make mud
or brown.
Which is make brown.
Mm-hmm.
So you do little squirts, not a lot. A couple of places wherever you want them. And there's more colors over here.
Well,
let's set these down the way so they can dry. This one too. We'll put a fresh one over there. That's too much. You gotta do skinnier amounts. You don't need any other colors. That's way enough paint.
So what do I do, really?
Yep. What's your predominant color right now?
Red.
Because?
Came out too fast.
Yeah. Okay, now you could roll it on here or you could leave it on the brayer. It's up to you what you want to do. You can pick a stencil. I don't have too many. I need to get some.
Yeah.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Leave it right there.
It's like purple.
And lay it down. Pick a stencil and you lay it over. So which one do you want to do? Okay. Okay. So what you're going to do is you're going to take a piece of paper over the bottom.
And push.
And over the top.
Can I push on that one?
Yep. You're just going to do the same thing we did before and make sure you don't let your paper move. You hold it with one hand and then rub with the other. We're going to move this over. Wait. Go ahead and pick this up and you're going to lay it here. And then we're going to put papers on the stencil. And we're going to get the ink off the stencil. So we're going to do the same exact thing. I'm going to rub it hard because the ink will start drying if it's a thin layer. Or if it's hot, like it's hot in the house, so you have the reverse, because this one picked up the flower, and these are picking up the outside of the flowers, so those are pretty.
Okay,
so you'll leave that. Now, that one is going to have the design of the flowers, so we're going to do the same thing and pick up what's left. That's okay. Look how cool.
It looks like an eyeball.
Okay, so pick a couple more colors. Look at all this ink on the side.
You want to go next?
Hmm?
You want to go next?
No, go ahead. Take a couple new colors. Just make sure you use small amounts of it. And if it's liquidy, like when you hear it sloshing, you know to squeeze it more gently. So we're going to do the same thing, but instead of picking up the last one after we remove the stencil, we're going to add another color of paint over it.
Okay.
And don't forget there's some of these colors, the purples and the browns, the white and black. Not the metallics or any of those.
Okay. like
that one's my favorite. That one's poppy.
I can hear your computer making noise.
Mm-hmm. Left it on. You gotta do it fast because it's gonna start drying out. Up and down, it mixes the colors more, and sometimes you like that, sometimes not. Are you done?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
Looks like an H.
Mm-hmm, it does. Okay, so you're gonna lay one down. So nice and soft and mushy, huh?
Mm-hmm. Just like real chili.
Oh, totally forgot to do the stencil part. Oh well. Let me get in there and I'll do one real quick. I'm going to do the flower one. This white has water in it. So does this purple. It's very liquidy.
I can see that.
Okay. So. I'm going to make sure I don't have any of these colors on.
Really pretty.
So now we're going to do this. This is the stuff I totally forgot. Okay, put a paper on and rub it. Over here, take this off, and then we're gonna put the papers on and rub it off of here.
Oh, nope.
Now I'm gonna put another color over the top of this one and see what we get. So purple and white
and blue. Chunky.
Okay, so with this one color, I'm trying to redo the whole thing to cover over all the color that's on there. And the other colors will remain.
Well, it means black.
No, it's not black. It's the end of the roller, taking the color off. Okay.
Looks like blue.
So now, we're going to put paper on and pick up what's on there.
I already did this.
No, this. I'm going to put one on. Make sure you don't let it slide. Hold it in place with one and rub it really good.
so pretty.
So now what I want to do
is... Should I get that off?
Yeah, I want to try to use it.
It's going to make her sweet scent color.
It's going to make mud. That's okay.
Looks
like fire. Mm-hmm. See that little bit? A lot of times that actually works better. So I'm going to do a different sensor. Where's this one? You want to go over that part? I'm going to use some of these. I like that one, so I'm going to use that. I'm going to go a little bit this way.
Ooh. That's pretty.
Let me see. Oh, yeah, I see. You got all those little harlequins. That's what it's called.
Harlequins.
Yeah, they look like skinny diamonds. See how I cleaned it up? And then that is actually underneath. So that's got a lot of purples. So now, I'm going to let you do the stencil. Go over with this one. And I'm going to go with this. Yeah, that's why the paint dries so faster. Now, you can see there's still some extra on here, so I'm just going to go over it where I want some more. Like, I might want that right in here, so I'm going to try to aim for it. Ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate you watching Roberta's Artistic Adventures with her granddaughter Cheyenne trying out the new jelly plate. Hope you enjoyed. Give us a thumbs up. If you like what we're doing, you could subscribe and share. We appreciate your support. Thank you. Have a blessed day. Bye.
Bye.